5G home internet service is starting to become a popular alternative to expensive cable and fiber connections. But is it really all it's cracked up to be for your typical home user? And then what about business use? Well, in order to find out, I walked into my local T-Mobile store and walked out 30 minutes later with this T-Mobile home internet modem. And for the past month, I've been putting it through its paces to figure out the pros and cons of 5G home internet service. So let's hop right into my review of T-Mobile home internet. I have been wanting to try out T-Mobile home internet for a while now. It's a 5G based internet service that's $50 a month with no service contract. If you already have a T-Mobile cell phone account, their 5G home internet service drops down to just $25 a month. And that sounds like a pretty good deal overall, with one big caveat. You have to be in an area that has solid 5G coverage. There are also now similar 5G home internet options from both Verizon and AT&T, but T-Mobile was really the first to market with this type of service, and I chose to test out T-Mobile because, number one, I can't stand AT&T just due to past difficulties with their services, and my past two Verizon cell phones both have had horrendous 5G and 4G LTE data speeds. It's sometimes completely unusable in areas that should have great coverage. So I wanted to try out something different. Now I should start out with a disclaimer here. I have absolutely zero affiliation with T-Mobile. I've not been paid by them or contacted by them as part of this review. The $50 a month service charge is coming straight out of my own pocket. Now, I started my T-Mobile home internet experience by just walking into one of their store locations at a local strip mall, and I started asking about it. And then 30 minutes later, I walked out with this home internet router. Super easy to get set up and running with their service. My purchase also included a $100 rebate for signing up, which is essentially 2 months free, and T-Mobile seems to be running various promotions all the time. They were like putting on the full court press to get me to switch my Verizon phones over to T-Mobile's service with some pretty crazy promotions. I think they said they'd pay off our phones up to like $900 or $1,000 per phone, and it included free Netflix or Disney Plus or something. I mean, it was definitely compelling, and I'm not someone who's in love with Verizon. I might actually just switch over to T-Mobile. If only they'd stop getting hacked and leaking everyone's data all over the internet. So let's talk about the modem itself. Now it's not too big, measuring 4.5 inches by 4.5 inches and then 7.5 inches tall. Now they recommend placing it in a window for the best signal, which makes perfect sense, right? The front here features a display screen that has some limited stats about the connection. You've got connection status, devices connected, messages, and language settings. The messages is actually pretty interesting. So since I'm a T-Mobile home internet customer, but I don't have a T-Mobile cell phone, they had to give me a phone number as part of the internet service. And apparently the phone number that they gave me gets phishing spam because I had a bunch of like reset your Facebook spam texts in the messages section on the display of the front of the modem. I had to go in and like delete all those out. The back of the device features a USB-C connector for power. It also has a secondary USB-C connector, which does seem to be non-functional, but will supply power if you want to use it to charge up your devices. And then it has 2 1-gigabit Ethernet ports so that it can be directly connected to a device such as a laptop or desktop computer, or you can use the Ethernet port to plug your T-Mobile home internet connection into the WAN port of a router to supply internet to your own home networking gear. Plugging directly into the WAN port of your home router does work fine, but I had a couple of hiccups when I first tried it. My test network is a UniFi UDM Pro, and when I plugged into the WAN interface, the T-Mobile home internet modem was negotiating at 100 megabits instead of full gigabit, which means that my speed tests were never actually going above 100 megabits. Now, after some fiddling around with the 2 different Ethernet ports on the back of the T-Mobile modem, as well as rebooting the UDM Pro, it did end up negotiating at 1 gigabit. I'm not sure what actually ended up fixing it, but it has remained solidly connected ever since. When you do plug into your WAN port, the IP address provided by the T-Mobile home internet modem is a private IP address. In my case, it was 192.168.12.x. This means that it is going to be double NATed, and it doesn't appear that they have the option for like a bridge mode or even an option for a static IP address. In fact, it seems there's no static IP address options for either the home internet or the small business internet service. The modem's integrated Wi-Fi is 4x4 MIMO Wi-Fi 6, and it definitely takes advantage of those speeds. So let's hop right into some of the speed testing. Of course, all speed testing is going to be completely anecdotal, right? Since there are so many variables. You've got the device running the test, T-Mobile's signal to the 5G network, whatever geographical area you're in, other interference. I mean, you guys get the idea. So take any speed test with a grain of salt. But in my experience with the service, it actually has been pretty solid. I regularly see daytime speed tests of around 350 megabits per second from my iPhone 14 directly to the wireless on this T-Mobile modem. From my PC directly to the T-Mobile modem, speeds are a little bit lower, but not by much, maybe like 10 or 15% lower, but also, you know, my computer's under my desk and there's, you know, other variables involved. If I connect the T-Mobile modem to the WAN interface of the Ubiquiti UDM Pro that's in my test network back here, and then run the same speed test through a U6 Lite access point from either my phone or my desktop PC, the speeds are quite a bit lower. But keep in mind that it's not a perfect wireless environment because I'm basically running speed tests through an access point that's sitting inside of a big metal box, right? That definitely affects the signal. However, with proper access point placement and some fine tuning, I actually have no doubt that you could achieve speeds close to what you get when you're connecting to the T-Mobile home internet modem directly. So then why would you even want to plug the T-Mobile home internet into the WAN port of a different network in the first place? Well, the answer there is pretty simple, right? Since T-Mobile home internet service needs to be placed in a window, and preferably whichever window in the house gets the best sort of, you know, most consistent signal, that location may not be the best place for the T-Mobile modem's onboard wireless to reach your entire home, right? So if you use your own router firewall and your own access points, you have much more scalability and control over how you distribute this wireless signal out to your devices. By and large though, having the T-Mobile home internet on the second floor of my home in a window out the front of the house does seem to have fairly good coverage for the entire home, though it probably wouldn't stretch too far into my backyard, which is on the other side of the house. The built-in wireless is pretty good for a normal size single family home. And of course, while running speed tests can give you a nice point in time view of the internet speeds at any particular time, what about the consistency? So in order to measure consistency, I set up a small Raspberry Pi configured with the Ookla speed test CLI client writing to a database and then graphed that database with Grafana. I ran a speed test every 30 minutes for more than a month to get a good view of the internet speed tests over time. The Raspberry Pi was hardwired directly into the T-Mobile home internet modem in order to eliminate any sort of like wireless interference with those speed tests. So now let's take a look at the graphed results over time. Here in the 30-day view, you can see that speeds were fairly consistent, hitting upwards of 600 megabits per second at nighttime and between 250 to 300 megabits during the daytime. Now let's also zoom in a bit to a 7-day view. Again, here you can see decent consistency in speeds over time. So for 50 bucks a month and these kinds of speeds, this is a perfect home internet solution, right? Well, maybe not so fast there. So while the speeds are great, I did have a few bumps and hiccups with the service. So for instance, every so often, if I was browsing the internet on my phone, all of a sudden, you know, pictures would stop loading or it'd become sluggish. I mean, it would usually clear itself up after a couple minutes, but it was enough to make me hop back onto my hardwired Comcast Xfinity cable connection, which never has those kinds of issues. So this probably happened maybe a half a dozen times over the course of a month that I was testing this thing out. Overall though, hiccups aside, I am impressed with the T-Mobile home internet service. Signing up for service and setting up the modem in my home was incredibly simple. I mean, even the most technologically challenged individuals would have a tough time messing it up. The pricing is great, right? So for 50 bucks a month at these speeds, or like 25 bucks a month if you're already a T-Mobile cell phone user, I mean, that's really hard to beat. My other internet connection is a Comcast Business 600 by 40 cable connection that I pay almost 350 bucks a month for. I mean, it pains my wallet every month I have to pay that bill. But since I run a business out of my home, I really like the solid connectivity. We're gonna get back to that in just a moment. In comparison with a service such as Starlink, T-Mobile home internet is faster and cheaper. My Starlink service is 110 bucks a month, and I usually get between 80 to 150 megabits per second. twice as expensive, and much slower than T-Mobile home internet. But I can also use Starlink in very remote locations, whereas you have to be in a 5G coverage area for this T-Mobile device to work. So I love that there's no contract, I love that I can cancel any time with no penalty, and I love that they've got some crazy good promotions to incentivize people to sign up. Now the internet connectivity is okay, it's mostly fine, it's definitely not perfect. I have no issues with the speeds I was getting, but I did have those occasional hiccups with the internet browsing, slowness, pictures not loading, etc. So for the like normal home user, and I'm not talking about like super power users that are watching these YouTube videos, I'm talking about your parents' house, right? So where they're doing basic web surfing, they're, you know, using some Netflix or streaming services to watch TV, this is gonna be a totally usable internet connection. Although, your experience with 5G internet is gonna vary based on 1,000 different variables, including how far are you from a 5G tower? How many other people are using the 5G tower in your area? What kind of wireless interference is there? Where do you have the modem placed in your house? All sorts of different variables, you guys get the point. So now let's talk about power users and business users. In my opinion, this may not be your best primary internet option, right? The occasional sluggishness and dropouts would be super, super frustrating if you're trying to work from home or run your business off of this internet. The double NAT situation is terrible for voice over IP and other real-time services. The lack of any static IP address options definitely could be an issue if your business WAN IP can't be dynamic for some reason. All of that being said though, this is an excellent backup internet option for power users and businesses. If you want a relatively inexpensive way to mitigate primary internet outages, or perhaps provide a completely separate open Wi-Fi network for like guests or non-critical network traffic, T-Mobile home internet is actually a pretty great choice. And that's exactly how I'm using it, right? So I'm gonna use this as a backup internet connection. My entire business is online, right? So it has to be highly available. It's worth 50 bucks a month for me to have a backup internet connection that can provide me with high-speed internet if my Comcast connection goes down. And if you have a dual WAN router, you can use this as a secondary failure, or as I mentioned previously, route some of your non-critical traffic, like guest stuff, down this connection. So now you've heard my experience with T-Mobile home internet. I'd love to hear about your experience with this product. You can comment below, and any and all feedback is gonna be great to help out other people who may be investigating this internet service option. In the meantime, if you wanna keep this party going, I have selected two videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my initial setup and review of Starlink, and the bottom video is a comprehensive explanation of Wi-Fi 6 and whether or not it's worth upgrading.